the treatment, right? Okay. For treatment, several drugs are taken to ensure that the bacteria is completely killed. Several drugs are taken to ensure that the bacteria is completely killed. Not doing so, that is if you don't take several drugs, not doing so develops drug resistant forms. Not doing so develops drug resistant forms. That is, we need to take a combined antibiotic therapy. That is, we need to take a combined okay, so why do we need to take combined antibiotic therapy? Okay, so you write down the reasons for why we need to take a combined, because one antibiotic taken for tuberculosis is not going to be effective. Okay, the bacteria for tuberculosis is very dramatic. It will completely go silent inside your body, and you know, it will give you the impression that you're completely better and you're cured, and then after some time it will then strongly come back again, right? And so this is it's a very dramatic kind of a situation. Then, you know, also when you inhale, it will remain silent for weeks and years and years, and then, you know, suddenly it causes the disease. So because it behaves in such unpredictable manner, which is why we need to control it by, you know, from jitna bhi enemy hamara strong hota hai, we use multiple weapons to, you know, make sure that the especially if the enemy is changing the mode of attack, you know, we'll see how the tuberculosis bacteria changes its antigen. It constantly mutates, and because it mutates, it changes its antigen, it hides inside the body cells, so it becomes a little difficult to catch hold of the bacteria by using one antibiotic. So bacteria are likely to resist one antibiotic. Bacteria are likely to resist one antibiotic, which is why combined antibiotics are given. Bacteria is very likely to resist one antibiotic, which is why combined antibiotics are given. This ensures that the development of the drug resistant form is small. This ensures that the chances for the development of drug resistant form is small. This ensures that the chances for the development of drug resistant forms is small, right? Number two, the bacteria mutates constantly. Now, because the bacteria is constantly mutating, it is changing its antigen. It is changing its weapon by which it is producing damage. If I have one enemy and I know that the enemy always attacks using one kind of a weapon, so I will form defenses against that one weapon. I will develop anti-weapon, whatever strategy that I can, because I know that what the weapon is. But if the enemy is constantly changing their weapons, then I'm helpless. I don't know how to defend myself. So this is the similar case with the bacteria, which is with the mycobacterium, that it constantly changes its antigen. And because it's constantly changing its antigen, which is called antigenic variation, this term of constantly changing antigen is called antigenic variation, right? So it is because of this that we need to take multiple antibiotics at the same time. We need to take a combined antibiotic therapy. Okay? Then another problem with the bacteria is that it hides inside the body cell. It will go and hide inside the lungs. It will go and hide inside the bones. It will go and hide inside the lymph nodes. It will go and hide inside the intestines, and that term is called antigenic concealment, and this term is called antigenic. That is, the bacteria is hiding inside the body cells and tissues. It's not very easy to reach the bacteria, right? Then again, we need to take multiple antibiotics. Okay, the mycobacterium grows and divides very slowly. Like I said, it will remain quiet inside your body, it will not grow, you know, finding a more favorable time, maybe it could take months and weeks, you know, and then suddenly it starts to grow and then it, you know, starts to produce the harm on a very large scale. So it grows and divides very slowly, which is why we need to control it by taking multiple antibiotic therapy. Okay. Multiple antibiotics ensure that all the bacteria are killed completely. Multiple antibiotics ensure that all the bacteria are killed completely, not letting any bacteria remain behind, not letting any bacteria remain to start up, to act as a reservoir of infection, not letting any bacteria remain to become a reservoir of infection. So this is why we need to take, and we discussed that the bacteria constantly, you know, what happens is that, for example, I'm taking one antibiotic, so the bacteria, the susceptible bacteria will be killed, and due to spontaneous mutation, some of the bacteria will develop resistance to that one particular antibiotic, right? So, if I'm taking, let me say that, you know, this is the drug. This is the drug, and it has killed some of the bacteria, right? It has killed some of the bacteria. It has killed majority of the bacteria which were susceptible, right? The susceptible ones have been killed. Some bacteria develop resistance to this drug. Some bacteria develop resistance to drug A, right? Drug A killed 80% of the bacteria. Some 20% or maybe 10% or 5%, they escape, being killed, and due to spontaneous mutation or due to any factor that they had resistance against drug A, and they survive. Now when they survive, then they multiply, right? So they increase the, they were resistant, so they survived. And when only they survived and they multiply and grow now, so they increase the drug resistant forms. Okay? They increase the drug resistant forms. So this is basically what happens. Like, for example, I just gave drug A, and 80% of the bacteria was susceptible to drug A and they were killed. But just like 5% or 10%, they escaped being killed because they had some resistance in them to drug A, or they underwent mutation, right? And their antigen was slightly different from what their drug was actually made against, right? And if they escape because they are resistant for any reason, and then now when they will multiply because they survived, right? And now when they multiply, they increase the drug resistant forms. So this is what happens, that, you know, we give a lot of antibiotics at the same time. So maybe if this drug A did not work and 10% escaped, then maybe drug B is able to tackle the resistant forms, you know, if drug B fails, maybe drug C. So this is how we are trying to control the bacteria using multiple drugs, right? Okay. Then for the second part of the treatment, you will write down that when tuberculosis is confirmed, in a person when tuberculosis is confirmed, that is when the person is considered positive for tuberculosis, for the bacteria, right? The patient needs to be isolated. The patient needs to be isolated. That is, the patient needs a quarantine, right? Needs to be quarantined for 2 to 3 weeks while the bacteria is in its most infectious stage. Because the first 2 to 3 weeks are very infectious stages of the bacteria and the transmission rate is very, very high. So the person is very, very strongly having the potential to spread the disease to all the people that are around that person for the initial 2 to 3 weeks after confirming the positive bacteria in their body fluids, right? That person needs to be isolated so that while the bacteria is passing through its infectious stages, the bacteria is not transferred and transmitted to the people around. Okay? Then such a person requires a long-term treatment regime. The person requires a long-term treatment regime, which could be 6 months, 12 months, 2 years or even more. The treatment regime could be for as long as 6 months, 12 months, 2 years or even more. Okay? Taking multiple antibiotics, right? Now, within the treatment, you will write down the drugs which are taken for tuberculosis, right? The drugs, they basically fall into two categories. We have the first line of drugs and the second line of drugs, right? The first line of drugs are isoniazid and the first line of drug therapy is using drugs called isoniazid and rifampicin. Okay, the second line of drugs is ciprofloxacin, quinolone, LON. And aminoglycosides. Sorry, not metformin. But aminoglycosides. Okay, these are the ciprofloxacin, quinolone, and aminoglycosides. So the first line of drugs, that is the first line of drugs ka matlab hai, less strong drugs. Second line of drugs are more strong drugs. So isoniazid and rifampicin form the first line of the drug therapy. Then ciprofloxacin, quinolone, and aminoglycosides, they form the second line of the drug therapy. Okay. Next is why treatment fails. We are still discussing treatment, right? Now we are going to talk about actually why the treatment fails. We use these drugs, but why there are strong chances of the treatment to fail. Treatment ke andar hi hum abhi discuss kar rahe hain. So now we need to know why there are strong chances of the treatment to fail. There are strong chances for the drug therapy and the treatment to fail with tuberculosis is because the bacteria has a very long latent period. The bacteria has a very long, you know, these questions are the different questions from the past papers, which is why I'm making you write under different subheadings within the treatment only, because they've been asked in the various past, in the past papers. All right. The treatment fails because the bacteria has a very long latent period. Has a very long latent period. Okay. The drugs may be unavailable or unaffordable. The drugs may be unavailable or unaffordable. Obviously, if you're a third world citizen, then it's not very, very easy to get the drugs. Sometimes the drugs are unavailable, right? If there's a shortage, too much of, you know, endemic, too much of a disease, so maybe they are unavailable. Or they may be also unaffordable, you know. The socioeconomic status is not very, very strong. Person is a very lower middle class, lower, you know. You cannot, everybody cannot afford expensive drugs, especially people belonging to the third world countries, right? Poor countries, all right. Then, so the drug may be unavailable or unaffordable. Then, failure to adhere to the long-term treatment regime. Failure to adhere to the long-term treatment regime, because the treatment schedule is very, very long, for 9 months, for 1 year, for 2 years, for even more, you know. You know, you forget the dose, you skip the dose, you skip a day, you skip 2 days, you forget. So that is all, you know, the treatment is failing because you are promoting the development of the drug-resistant forms and you're not going to get well. So that's a very strong reason, that is failure to adhere to the long-term treatment regime. Then incomplete treatment. Like I said, the bacteria is very, very dramatic, right? You take a dose for 3 weeks and the signs and symptoms are completely gone. The bacteria will just go and hide inside your body, stop any harm, you know, the immediate harm which is being produced. And you think that, oh, it's better, theek ho gayi. Toh mujhe kuch khaansi bhi nahi hai, kuch bhi nahi hai, main bilkul theek ho gayi. And you know, psychologically, then you don't take your medication or you skip your medication. You start becoming less, concerned with taking your treatment. And that is when the bacteria gets a chance now to develop the drug-resistant forms and to attack with double the strength from what it was in the first attack, right? The bacteria will now attack with double the strength from what it was in the previous attack. So these are the different situations: long latent period, unavailability, unaffordability of the drug, failure to adhere to long treatment schedule, and incomplete treatment. These factors, they all collectively lead to the fact that the treatment is going to fail. No matter you are taking the drugs, but if you are skipping doses, skipping days, you know, your treatment is going to fail. Now, we have different types, the drug resistant types. Iske baad treatment pe hi hum likh rahe hain. Okay, we have another heading. Yeah? Drug resistant types of the strains, the drug resistant strains. इसी के अंदर है why the treatment fails is because we have the points that I'm dictating while I'm teaching are the points that relate to your questions from the past papers. They are the answers for P1 and P2, right? So collectively, in another way, as I'm teaching, I'm also discussing the past paper questions. I'm giving you the answers for different MCQs and for different, which is why I have these subheadings. All right. So we talk about the drug-resistant strains. There are three types of drug-resistant strains of tuberculosis. The three types of the drug-resistant strains are NBR, multiple drug resistant strains, XT are extremely drug resistant and PDR. Total drug resistance chain. Alright. Now you will write down that the MDR strains. The MDR strains are resistant to the first line of drugs. The first line of drugs are isoniazid and rifampicin, you know. So the multiple drug resistant strains will not respond if you're giving such patients isoniazid and rifampicin. So they are resistant to the first line of drug treatment. Okay. The extremely drug resistant strains are resistant to the first line of drugs. And they're also resistant to the drugs taken for MDR. Extremely drug resistant strains are resistant to the first line of drug therapy and also to the drugs which are taken for the MDR. ठीक है? Double the strength है ना, तो first line of drug therapy को भी resist करेंगे and also they will resist the drugs which are taken for controlling the MDR strains. Then the total drug resistant strains, they resist both, they resist the drugs which are used as treatment for MDR and PDR. They resist both the drugs which are used for MDR and PDR. And to control tuberculosis due to TDR strains, we need to take a great combination of antibiotics and the treatment needs to be carried on for 2 or more years. To control tuberculosis due to the XDR strains requires multiple strong antibiotics, ठीक है, which need to be taken for 2 or more years. Now ये ऐसे होता है कि मुझे पहले tuberculosis हो गया और जनाब मैंने उसका treatment लिया, पूरा course नहीं किया, incomplete treatment, not proper dose, I felt better and I stopped taking. So the MDR strains will now develop into extremely drug resistant strains within my body only because I gave them the chance. I did not complete or followed up my treatment and now the MDR is developing to XDR. अब XDR के साथ भी obviously 9 months, 1 साल तक दवाई खाना भूल जाता है बंदा, you know. And then if that happens, then now I'm giving the chance of the bacteria within my body only to develop into TDR. ठीक है? So it is because of my negligence that I am giving the bacteria the chance to develop from MDR to XDR. From XDR to TDR, right? That is how the multiple drug resistant forms develop. And because there is a very high occurrence of these drug resistant forms, which is why generally it becomes very difficult to control tuberculosis. Okay, then we discuss the reasons for developing the drug resistant strains. What are the reasons for developing? Okay, what are the reasons for developing the drug resistant strains? We just spoke so much about the drug resistant strains. So what are the actual reasons for developing the drug resistant strains? Again, you will write down, this again has come, is a question from the past papers. Okay, because the bacteria mutates, number one, antigenic variation leads to the development of drug resistant strains. Okay. Spontaneous mutation in the bacteria. For any reason, the susceptible ones died and the resistant ones survived, and now when they multiply and they grow, they increase their drug resistant forms. Yes? For any reason, the susceptible ones died and for any reason, some of the bacteria escape that drug and they survive by developing resistance to that one particular drug. So now, because the drug resistant forms have survived and now they're going to multiply and grow, so this is how they increase the drug resistant forms. Okay. If the tuberculosis is not treated completely, we favor the development of the drug resistant forms. If the tuberculosis is not treated, and also if the treatment is not carried out for the required duration, if the treatment hi na mila ho, theek hai, phir treatment mila ho aur phir uska proper duration follow nahi kiya ho. There are two different aspects. Ek to kisi ko pata hi nahi chala us gareeb ko treatment hi nahi mila, right? Dawai nahi mil sakti kyunki mehngi thi ya afford nahi kar sakta tha ya available nahi thi kisi gaon mein dehat mein, right? To usko treatment hi nahi mila. So that they will develop drug resistant form. Or kisi ko treatment mila ho, they got the treatment, but they were not able to carry out for the proper duration of the requirement, the time period for which the duration was required to carry out the treatment. You know, if that was the case, then again they lead to the development of drug resistant forms. Theek hai? Treatment mila tha, but carry out nahi ho saka properly. Pura time period uska hum 2 saal tak nahi dawai kha sake. Hum 1 saal tak dawai nahi kha sake. Right? So then again we are promoting the development of the drug resistant forms, right? Okay, then the last subheading is prevention and control. Prevention and control. How can you prevent and how can you control tuberculosis? How can you prevent and how can you control tuberculosis? Prevention and control, जो भी causative agents हैं, जो भी factors lead करें, उनको हम उल्टा कर दें तो prevention बन जाता है. Okay. Oh, right. Mass vaccination. It can be largely controlled by providing mass vaccination, and a term used for mass vaccination is called herd immunity. It's called herd immunity. You know, when the vaccination programs are carried out, they just don't go and vaccinate one person who they think is might be suffering from tuberculosis, but they vaccinate all the people in that small community, all the people around the area, all at one time, all at one go. That is to break the transmission cycle. So when that's called herd immunity. Lot of people, the entire village was vaccinated at the same time, right? Or if it's a refugee camp, all the refugees in the camp were vaccinated at the same time. That is called achieving herd immunity. So if you achieve herd immunity with tuberculosis, the control rate is very good. Okay. The vaccination that is used is called, the vaccination which is used for as a preventive measure to control tuberculosis is called BCG. It is an abbreviation for Bacillus Calmette. I need to be very sure with the spellings because you also have to be very sure with the spellings. If you don't write proper spellings, then the CI have changed their trend from last year onwards that they deduct your marks. Okay? Guerin. Bacillus Calmette Guerin. BCG. The BCG vaccine stands for Bacillus Calmette Guerin. It is a very closely related strain. It's also a bacteria. It's a closely related strain to the mycobacterium. It is a closely related strain to the mycobacterium, which is less virulent. It is less virulent. It is not so virulent as the mycobacterium, but it's very closely related. So when we inject this into the body develops an immune response. Basically, vaccination work, we'll do this in more detail in the next chapter. The main concept of the vaccinations, behind vaccinations to make them work is that you actually introduce the antigen in a very small dose into the body. That small dose is a dose enough to give the body a chance to recognize the antigen and to develop an immune response. But that dose is not strong enough to actually cause the disease inside your body. You know, like they keep on giving people polio drops. So polio drops wo itne de rahe hote hain ki aapki body usko identify karke immune response create kar le, aur itne zyada nahi pilane chahiye. Kuch aise hue bhi accidentally that they gave so much of the drops that they actually caused polio in people, right? So if the health workers are not actually acquainted and they give you more drops, so basically the dose should be not in the amount to produce the disease, but the dose is given in an amount to give the body an idea of what the antigen is like, so that your body can prepare an immune defense, right? Defensive attack. Body pehle se defense system apna strong kar leti hai, so that accidentally when you do come across that bacteria inside your body, the body is well prepared from before and it will kill the bacteria before the bacteria gets a chance to create damage inside your body, right? That is the main idea behind vaccination. So when people are born, newborn babies, right, are given the BCG vaccine. The BCG vaccine is coming from Bacillus calmette, where it's a close, it's very close type for bacteria, which has the same makeup as the mycobacterium tuberculosis, right? And they give it in a small dose so that the body recognizes the antigen and can develop an immune response against it. And when you actually do come across tuberculosis, the bacteria aapki body mein aayega, to aapki body usko aate hi usko ekdam se attack karke maar degi. Alright. So then we have so it's a closely related strain to the mycobacterium, which is less virulent. It does not cause infection, but stimulates your immune system. It does not cause infection, but it stimulates your immune system to produce a strong secondary response. But it stimulates your immune system to produce a strong secondary response. What do we mean by a primary response? And what we mean by a secondary response, we'll do it in detail in the next chapter. So you know what I mean by the strong secondary response, right? Okay, then this, a very common question, right? It's come a lot of times in the past papers as to why do we need to inject the vaccine. Polio ke drops to orally dilate hai na, but BCG ko inject kyun karte hai? Agar class hoti to I would have asked you the question and I would have seen ki kitne log jawab de sakte hain iska. But unluckily, we can't have that. But why we inject the vaccine is because the vaccine, if taken orally, will be killed by the acid of the stomach, right? If we take the vaccine orally, this bacillus will be killed by the acidic environment of the stomach, which is why we need to inject it, take it directly into the bloodstream, and it doesn't get this, you know, it doesn't get destroyed, and it gives the immune system a chance to recognize and to produce a secondary immune response. Polio vaccine is given orally because it cannot be destroyed by the acid of the stomach. Or if polio ki drop bahut zyada bhi pila de to wo actually polio bhi kar dete hain, kar sakte hain, right? So ek ya do drops hi dalte hain. Okay, so this collectively winds up the entire knowledge that is needed for the tuberculosis. And while I explained and I taught, I also discussed a lot of questions that were related to past papers, P1 MCQ questions and your structured paper questions. You have the worksheets with you, and please start solving the questions, the P1 and the P2 questions from the worksheets, right? Okay, thank you very much.